creepy as that, Chef Clem? Did you see? And he was actually checking out to see if she's actually scanning, and she is. Shout outs to you, Jamie Lee. Are you also going to donate? Have you donated?
I've been donating, and I think it's a great way to actually make a difference. It's so easy. It's never been easier for you to be part of something that's so great. Mm. And right now, I think the smallest little bit that we can do, especially with, like, weather's changing, we need to, like, start thinking about our neighbours, our, like, everyone else. It makes you feel good to be part of something that's making such a huge difference.
You're all warm inside.
Yeah.
And I love that, the act of giving back. Now we're back in the kitchen making something that has all the savory goodness for this winter season. Chef Clem, what are we making?
We're making a brinjal lasagna.
Brinjal lasagna.
Yeah. So brinjal is not just an emoji, okay?
AKA what?
It's also called eggplant. Brinjal was another aubergine. It's got some other names, but what's it in Vernac? What is it in Vernac?
I don't know what it is in Vernac, in Xhosa.
To our viewers at home, if you know what it's called in, like, any other names you have for brinjal, let us know on social media.
Oh, Jamie has something.
Jamie has a name.
She said something about blow something.
Oh, I can't say that on TV. I can't say that name on TV.
Okay.
But yeah, on social media, maybe so one of our viewers can drop the name on there.
Okay. But let me attempt though. Okay, eggplant.
Eggplant.
In Xhosa, direct translation of an eggplant, ikanda le blom.
Who knows? Let us know.
Okay, let's get into it.
It's not just about you learning at home. Sometimes we need the education, so let us know.
Yes, please, let us know.
Okay, so this is what I did was, I took the brinjal and I cut it into quarters, and I put it into a pot with shallots, and then I cooked it down. I'm trying to break down the texture of the brinjal, but I don't want to break it down too much that it goes mush. That's why I kept it in quarters. But at home, if you want, you can cut it into little squares and roast it like that. Now we're going to start building on flavor. I added some olive oil to that. I'm going in with some garlic. Instant flavor with the garlic going in. Then we're gonna go with some more chili because we can, and then salt and pepper again. So that's already, it smells amazing. If you blended that up, you'd make a beautiful brinjal dip. It would be so amazing. A little bit of cream cheese through it.
Dip?
Yeah.
What would you dip in it?
You like some crudité, some bread.
Okay.
Some going the opposite way now. We're doing vegetarian, but it would dop some like some smoky sausages in there, just like in your mouth. Yeah, okay. I think it'd be amazing.
Okay. It smells so delicious, Clem.
It smells so good already. To this now, I want to add some tomatoes. Now, we always use tin tomatoes that's been chopped, but you also get the whole tomatoes, and sometimes they got a more intense tomato-y flavor when they're still whole. So what you do is you add them to your brinjals, and you let it cook. And then you actually smash it down later on, just break it up slightly. I also like the fact that you're not gonna break it down too much. You can keep chunks of tomato in this lasagna filling, which I think is absolutely amazing.
Oh, is that what we want? We want chunks also just coming through.
Absolutely, I mean, look at that tomato. So you can see once it cooks down a little bit more, it's already soft, but once everything's come together and it's beautiful and delicious, take a spoon and just kind of like break it up a little bit. Yeah. Keep the texture in there.
The recipes, it looks like the recipes are so simple and it's so quick to make
it
as well.
Is.
It's not as horrifying.
It's not. Absolutely. It's so delicious and so easy to put together. And again, we're not trying to say don't eat meat, but we're trying to say there's another option for you as well. So I think this is a great one. Let's talk about fresh herbs. Fresh herbs are a great way to add flavor to your dish. Any dish, any savory dish, sometimes even sweet dishes. They grow, like you just literally, this guy, we've just been watering it and it just grows, which is nice. It means you always have a supply of fresh herbs on hand. So all I do with this, all I just literally break it up, throw it in there, and that was some basil that went in. Basil stalks are also really great. So chop that up, throw it in there.
Okay.
Sage, we don't use a lot of sage. I don't know why, we should. It's great. It's super floral. I'm gonna give you some.
Yes, please, because I'd like to smell it.
It kind of like rub it between your hands. We washed our hands.
It's a very textured plant as
it
well.
Is. So thank you for saying this. So what you're gonna do is you wanna actually chop it up and break it down a bit and then add it to your filling.
Okay.
You like it?
I like it so much. And I feel like you can just grow it also in your kitchen and
you
it will
can.
Have that smell or aroma in your house as
Absolutely, you can. So then what we're gonna do now is we got some rosemary going in and I took that from your plant over there. That's why it's looking a bit short, okay? We've been trimming. So for the rosemary, I'm just gonna take the rosemary and then run my fingers along the stem and you get like all the little leaves come off. And
Just like that.
It's super easy. So that's gonna cook down. And then after about half an hour of cooking, we get this amazing filling. So let me just clear some space. By the way, on social media, on my Instagram, I ask people, what's your favorite comfort veggie dish? 90% of people, they all like cauliflower and broccoli with cheese sauce.
What?
And I get it. It's so comforting, but like,
what?
I meant like as a dish completely. I'm imagining all our viewers sitting at home there with like bucket, like, of cauliflower and cheese sauce. But hey, you know what I'll do? Actually, in the future, I'll actually make a delicious, like, broccoli cauliflower cheese
Please
sauce.
Do that for some of us. Viewers. We need to be converted. If you would like to get your hands on this delicious, healthy recipe, make sure to head on over to taste.co.za. Okay, so now we're layering out our lasagna.
Uh-huh. I'm doing a baby portion. This is for young Tabiso. This is for him. Then I'm taking our lasagna sheets. All I'm going to do is I'm just going to snap it. Just like that. I'm gonna kind of put it in there. Add another layer of the filling. Sprinkle some cheese over, a couple of almonds for crunchiness. Mm. It goes into the oven for 20 minutes and it comes out so delicious, so flavorsome. You're not gonna miss the meat. You're gonna be enjoying this for days.
And we're gonna put that right now in the oven, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And I can't wait for it to fill up my stomach.
Oh, it's gonna be so good.
Mm, absolutely. And also just with the filler bag campaign happening now that Wheaties has paired up with Gift of the Givers, it's an incredible initiative that we can all contribute towards to help someone with as little as 10 Rand, you can feed one person 3 meals a day.
I know. It's so easy.
Super.
True story, I gave my sister my old phone, all my banking details on it. She tells me she made a donation to Gift of the Givers. She used my phone, my account.
I love it so much. All right.
Thank you.